Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain.
Hello, a very good day to you. My name is Sister Temi Tayo, and I'm a Christian content creator, and I'm here to share the Open Heavens Daily Devotional compiled by the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. Now, if you're visiting my channel for the very first time, or if you know me personally, you may be asking why I'm sharing from this particular Christian book. The reason is because God instructed me to do so as I prepared to enter into the year 2020. So this is my fourth year of sharing, and that's why we call it season four. And all those videos, those Open Heavens videos from 2020, are all loaded on my YouTube channel. My handle on YouTube is Temi Agedo, which is right on the screen. I will encourage you to visit the channel to view the old Open Heavens devotional videos, and also most importantly to view the Open Heavens devotional video for the current day. And I know you'll be blessed as you listen. And while you're on my channel, please don't forget to subscribe, as that really helps my channel a lot. Pastor Adeboye led me to Christ in October 1997, a few years back, when I was an undergraduate in the University of Lagos, Nigeria, in West Africa. And Pastor gives you a few scriptures from the Bible. He gives you a memory verse. And when you combine those two pieces of scripture, it helps you to understand the body of the text and what the Spirit of God is saying to the reader of the daily devotional. Praise God. So today is Wednesday, June the 14th. Wednesday, June the 14th. And the title of today's daily devotional is Don't Be Afraid. Don't be afraid. Praise God. And our scriptural reading is taken from the book of Isaiah chapter 41 verses 10 to 20. Isaiah chapter 41 verses 10 to 20. And I'm going to be reading from the traditional King James Version. Today again is Wednesday, June the 14th. And the title is Don't Be Afraid. Praise God. God is speaking to us. So thus goes the reading of God's word from Isaiah 41 verse 10 to 20. Fear not, fear thou not, for I'm with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Behold, all they that are incensed against thee shall be ashamed and confounded. They shall be as nothing, and they that strive with thee shall perish. Thou shalt seek them and shalt not find them. Even them that contended with thee, they that war against thee, shall be as nothing and as a thing of naught. For I, the Lord thy God, will hold thy right hand, saying unto thee, Fear not, I will help thee. Fear not, thou worm Jacob, and ye men of Israel, I will help thee, saith the Lord, and thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. Behold, I will make thee a new sharp threshing instrument, having teeth. Thou shalt thresh the mountains and beat them small, and thou shalt make the hills as chaff. Thou shalt fan them, and the wind shall carry them away, and the whirlwind shall scatter them. And thou shalt rejoice in the Lord, and shall glory in the Holy One of Israel. When the poor and the needy seek water, and there is none, and their tongue faileth for thirst, I, the Lord, will hear them. I, the God of Israel, will not forsake them. I will open rivers in high places, and fountains in the midst of the valleys. I will make the wilderness a pool of water, and the dry land springs of water. I will plant in the wilderness the cedar, the shittah tree, and the myrtle, and the oil tree. And I will set in the desert the fir tree, and the pine, and the box tree together, that they may see, and know, and consider, and understand together, that the hand of the Lord had done this, and the Holy One of Israel had created this. Praise the Lord. Yes, so don't be afraid. Why are we not afraid? Because if God be for us, none can be against us. You know, and if you really want to know how, you know, God is on our side. God is for us amongst those that help us. See, he says, fear thou not. He's talking not only to Israel, but also to the body of Christ, to the Christian. So I personalize this. God is talking to me. He says, fear thou not, I'm with you. Don't be dismayed, I am your God. You know? He says, I will strengthen you and I will help you. I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Because there are times in life where some enemies that are stronger than you will come against you. You know, they will lift up a standard against you. But greater is he who is in us than he that is in the world. The God who delivered Israel from the hand of the Egyptians is the same yesterday, today, and forever. The Bible says he's called the man of war. In somewhere in the Old Testament, it says that the eyes of God run to and fro the earth that he may make himself strong on behalf of those whose heart is loyal to him. So God is, he said, fear thou not. He said, for I am the Lord, I will uphold thy right hand. That's verse 13. I will uphold thy right hand, saying unto thee, fear not, I will help thee. So God is our very present help in time of trouble. He will not leave us in the hands of the enemy. You know, and he will not condemn us when we are judged, according to Psalm 37. He says, fear thou not, fear not. And, you know, as human beings, the day will come when fear, something will happen to us. A Goliath will come against us, or the lion will roar against us. But then the Bible says that the Spirit of the Lord, you know, when the lion roared against Samson, the Bible says the Spirit of the Lord came upon him. You know, so when we go out there and something terrifies us, and you know, David, anytime he was afraid, he will always run to God. He said, when I'm afraid, I will trust in thee, you know. So and when we hide ourselves under the shadow of the Almighty, you know, nobody can touch us. The Bible says our lives are hid with Christ in God. So don't be afraid. And when you know, when fear comes, you know, open your mouth. I talk. I was speaking tongues loudly, and I say, God has not given to me the spirit of fear, but the spirit of power, of love, and of a sound mind. I am powerful, I am loving, and I am mentally sound. I refuse to fear. If God be for me, who can be against me? Hallelujah. Now, the memory verse is taken from the book of 1 John 4:18. God is for us. If God be for you, none can be against you. You know? And God has given an instruction. He said, the Bible says he rebuked kings for our sake, saying, touch not an anointed and do my prophets no harm. If you want to see God's red, the Bible says we are the apple of God's eye. Don't try touching the children of God. Don't try touching Israel. 1 John 4:18 says, there is no fear in love, but perfect love casted out fear, because fear had torment. He that feareth not is made perfect in love. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casted out fear, because fear had torment. He that feareth is not made perfect in love. We have to understand and know that God loves us with an everlasting love. The Bible says in the book of Romans that if God gave us Jesus Christ, he will freely give us all things. So, you know, sin is what brings fear. Sin is what brings fear. But we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, who was the propitiation for our sins. And that blood makes atonement for our soul. We know that God loves us, and he will not deal with us after our sins, nor punish us according to our iniquity. Don't be afraid. Our memory verse for today says that fear is a tormentor. According to 2 Timothy 1:7, fear is a spirit, and hence it is not a gift from God. Then it is from the devil. In Proverbs 29:25, God says the fear of man brings a snare. In other words, if you're afraid of a man, you fall into a trap. The reason many people run to witch doctors is fear, which is why they keep looking for protection against all kinds of enemies. So the reason why people go to witch doctors and look for alternatives to God is because they're afraid. You know? But I mean, there is no security anywhere, only in God. And pastor says that spirit, the fear is not from God. There is a fear that is the spirit of the fear of God. That is the spirit of holiness, you know. That's the Bible says, tremble thou, O art at the presence of God, so that we have a fear of God, a reverence. In fact, this is higher than reverence. The fear of God is what keeps us from sinning. It causes us to not sin. But that's a different kind of fear. It's an awesome fear, you know, that we tremble at his presence, you know, because he's God all by himself. But then there's a fear that maketh afraid, which is of Satan. That's not of God. And our memory verse said that when we know that God loves us, we will not be afraid. Amen. So the reason many people run to witch doctors is fear, which is why they keep looking for protection against all kinds of enemies. So when you're afraid of your village people, then you go to some witch doctor, somebody somewhere, to do some charm for you, to protect you against your village people. But pastor is saying to us here that it is fear that is driving you. It is fear that is moving you to go to witch doctors to seek solution elsewhere. You are afraid. And that's not of God. And you need to, that's a spirit that needs to be cast out. You speak the word of God against it. Hallelujah. One of the things that makes fear so terrible is that almost invariably, that which you are afraid of will come to you, as per Job 3:25. The fear of death has put many people in bondage today. The question now is everyone not going to die anyway? That's what Pastor is saying. Is the question now is everyone not going to die anyway? In Hebrews 9:25, it says that death is an appointment that everyone must keep. The devil keeps people in bondage because of something that they should be prepared for rather than afraid of. You know, Job was a righteous man. He feared God. So let's just say he was a Christian. But you know, he voiced his fear. He said, he voiced his fear. He said, and I was not in safety. He mentioned, he said that he was not in safety. He said it out. Meanwhile, Satan had gone to his house and seen that. He said to God, he said, you've made an edge around Job, around all his house. And, you know, so you've made an edge around Job and around all he has on every side. You have blessed the work of his hand and you caused his substance to increase in the land. But Job did not know. Instead, he voiced his fear. And it was the voicing of that fear that caused, that gave Satan an edge over him. You know, because he voiced his fear and that opened the door for Satan to come in. So don't talk about what you are afraid of. Talk about the awesomeness of the power of God and his word. Speak the word. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this I will be confident. Amen. So God will not leave me in the hands of mine enemies. No, he will deliver me from the hands of my enemies. I would have fainted unless I believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. You know, I love Psalm 27. And Pastor says that the fear of death is putting a lot of people in bondage. You know, and the answer to fear is the word of God. It is written. God has not given me the spirit of fear, but the spirit of power, love, and of a sound mind. It is written, fear not. I refuse to fear in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Greater, he has given his angels charge over me. You know, to preserve my going out and my coming in. I refuse to fear. Hallelujah. So, Pastor is saying that, you see, the question now is that is everyone not going to die? So why fear death? At a certain point in time, all of us are going to go. We've prayed that God will satisfy us with long life. Amen. You know, but we must understand that at a certain point in time, our time on earth is limited and we are going to go back to our Maker. So, the devil cannot keep anyone in bondage. You know, it's not something we should be afraid of. Rather, it's something that we should prepare for. Because the day is coming in righteousness when we stand before our Maker. So we should not be afraid of death. You know, Jesus Christ said something. He said, don't fear him that can destroy the body. He said, I'll tell you who you should fear. Fear God who has the power to destroy both body and soul in hell. So the only person that is to be feared is God Almighty. Amen. This is the only one that is to be feared. Nobody else. Hallelujah. The fear of a man bringeth a snare. So death is inevitable. So we should not be afraid of something that is going to happen, but rather we should prepare for it. Hallelujah. So if you're not born again, that means you're not prepared for the eventuality. Because if a man is not born again, he will not see the kingdom of God. That's what Jesus Christ said in John chapter 3, verse 3. When you have God with you, fear will get away from you. David said that the reason he had no fear, even in the valley of the shadow of death, is because he had the presence of God with him in Psalm 23, verse 4. Romans 8:15 says, you do not have the spirit of bondage to fear, rather that of adoption, giving you the right to call God our daddy. The true realization that you are a child of God and that God is with you always will chase fear out of your life. No child is afraid of a bully when his dad is standing beside him. As long as you are a child of God who lives holy, you can be sure that God is with you always. Our Bible reading for today says you should not be afraid, for God is with you. It says he will hold our hand and strengthen us. If you have God on your side, you have nothing to fear. Praise God. Sin is what brings fear. Sin brings fear. It brings condemnation. But then the Bible says to us in Romans chapter 8, verse 1, it says, there is therefore now no condemnation to us who are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made us free from the law of sin and death. So the spirit of fear is not from God. And, you know, even if Pastor says here, this is very important, that as long as you are a child of God who lives holy, you can be sure that God is with you always. God will never leave us or forsake us. That's one thing about God. He's a very present help in time of trouble. And you know, because God expected that we'll make mistakes, you know, he expected that we'll fall. And that's why Micah said, "Rejoice not over me, O my enemy, for if I fall, I rise again. Even if I sit in darkness, God is my light." You know, but do we not continue in sin that grace may abound? God forbid. You know, but God knows that we'll make mistakes, and that's why He gave us the weaponry of the blood of Jesus that maketh atonement for us, so that when we confess our sin, Christ is faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. He does not deal with us after our sins, and He does not punish us after our iniquity. God loves us with an everlasting love. You know, God is our Father in heaven. Just like, you know, your child may make a mistake, you don't throw the baby away with the bathwater, as they say. You know, because you know that he's growing up, and that, you know, you forgive him. Hallelujah. How much more our Heavenly Father? So Pastor says that as long as you're a child of God who lives holy, you can be sure that God is with you. So as a Christian, we should not put our hands into iniquity, because that brings fear. You know, Jesus Christ, the only problem, Jesus did not have, and our Lord Jesus, he didn't have any problem going to the cross at all. The problem he had was that because he was carrying the sins of the world, that God's presence at a certain time living, that was his problem. He said, "Oh God, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me." It was not because he was afraid. He came because he was there to carry, he wanted to die for mankind. So it wasn't the death that was the problem. It was the fact that when he became a partaker of Satan's nature, he would be separated from his Father. That was the problem that Jesus Christ had. It wasn't because he was afraid to go to the cross. No, at all. He had already decided that he was going to go to the cross. You know, that's why he came. But, and that's why he cried out on the cross, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani?" That means, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" That was the problem, that he would be separated from his Father. That was what he didn't want to deal with, you know, because and David said, "Lord, take not your Holy Spirit away from me." Hallelujah. Draw close to God and he will draw close to you, Pastor admonishes us as per James 4:8. This means that if you surrender your life to Jesus and you begin to live a holy life, God will come close to you and fear will disappear from your life. Sin will create a gap between you and God, and he won't even hear the prayers of unrepentant sinners, as per John 9:31, not to talk of saving them from danger. So Pastor says that, you see, God is holy, holy, holy. God, he says here that God does not hear the prayer of a sinner, of unrepentant sinners. You know, the blind man said that we know now that God does not hear sinners. And then in Proverbs, he tells us that the prayer of a sinner is an abomination to God. The only prayer of a sinner that God hears is the prayer of repentance. His ears are not dull that he cannot hear, or his hands short that he cannot save us. But our iniquities have separated him from us such that he cannot hear us and he cannot save us. So if you're a sinner, God does not hear sinners. The only prayer that he hears is the prayer of repentance, where you accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. So, you know, God, sin is a terrible thing. You know, sin is a terrible thing. God said to Adam, "The day you eat this fruit, you will surely die." And that was a spiritual death, a separation from God. The only thing I fear is for God to leave me, because if he does, I know I'm finished. This is why I live holy. I cannot afford to be away from his presence. What about you? Same here. God is the Spirit of God is everything to me. You know, and Pastor says the key point here is that God's presence drives away fear. As we hide under his shadow for protection and for deliverance. Amen. So may God deliver us from the power of sin, from the sins that so easily beset us, in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word. Father, Lord, I pray in the mighty name of Jesus Christ that you help us by the Spirit of God, by your word, and by the blood of Jesus to lay aside the sin that so easily besets us, that we may run with endurance this race you have set before us. Help us to hate what you hate in the name of Jesus. We confess that we love righteousness and we hate wickedness. Therefore, God, we ask that you anoint us with the oil of gladness above all our fellows. Father, Lord, wash us with the blood of Jesus Christ. Purge our consciences and our minds from dead work so that we can serve the living God. Help us, Almighty God, to hate sin with perfect hatred in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We refuse to fear because you have not given us the spirit of fear. In the name of Jesus Christ, we break and we cast out the spirit of fear from our lives in Jesus' name. Thank you, Heavenly Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Oh, wow, I've gone way over my time. Thank you so much for taking time to listen to me. I hope this blessed you. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Don't forget to subscribe. And God bless you. Have a good day.